Dear students, in the last exercise we saw how to solve biasing for D MOSFET, depletion MOSFET, by using the self-bias method. So we tried to, in that exercise, we tried to find out quiescent point, that is quiescent point, that is VDSQ and IDSQ, or quiescent Q point for bias point, we try to find out. But this bias point is not stable. This is because this quiescent point is not stable. This is variable because of the various parameter changes in the temperature, changes in the process parameter. So we would like to find out stable quiescent point. For that we are using one more method, that is called as voltage divider bias network. So voltage divider bias network is a stable for stable Q point. So now we will see, design a voltage divider bias network for stable Q point using DE MOSFET with the supply voltage of VDD 16 volt, IDSS 10 milliamperes, VP is equal to minus 5 volt, to have a quiescent drain current of 5 milliamps, and gate voltage of 4 volt. Assume drain resistance RD to be 4 times the source resistance resistor RS. So this is the problem statement. We need to find out voltage divider bias network. So this is the voltage divider bias network. Here you can see we have MOSFET, depletion N-channel MOSFET that is connected like this, and we have bias resistors R1, R2, RD and RS. RD is the drain resistance, RS is the source resistance, and when it is connected in this format, then it is called as voltage divider. Voltage divider method, this method. Here VDD is 16 volt, VDD is 16 volt. So now we need to find out in this case, actually, what is VDS, what is R1, R2, RD, RS. Suppose here in this example, if all the quantities like R1, R2, RS, RD, all are unknown, then it is very difficult to find out. So we will assume some of the parameters and we will try to find out other parameters. So we will start the method. Here in the example it says, as the quotient current, drain current, is less than drain current of 5 m, to have the quotient drain current of 5 milliamps and gate voltage of 4 volt. He says like, as the quotient drain current is less than saturation drain current, the MOSFET, see, because this one drain current is less than the saturation, the MOSFET operates in the depletion mode. In the depletion mode, this DE MOSFET either operates in the enhancement mode or depletion mode. But here, how to find out that one? In the last example, we saw VGS is equal to positive voltage. Because of that, we came to know that that MOSFET operate in enhancement mode. But here, taking this parameter, that like quotient drain current is equal to 5 mA, and that is less than IDSS. That's why it operates in. This is actually one of the parameter of the bias point. See, this is one of the parameter of the bias point. In the last example, I will take you to there. In the last example, you can see, the last example was to find out the Q point, where Q point involves VDSQ and IDSQ. SQ means quotient drain, and this one is IDSQ and VDSQ. We need to find out. So in this example, they have given this parameter. We have to find out this parameter by using voltage divider method.
So only one parameter is already known. So now here phi this one like phi m drain quotient drain current of quotient drain current of phi m is already known. So it is, he says it is less than IDSS. That's why the MOSFET operates in a depletion region. Now to find out the drain current ID, the formula is ID IDSS 1 minus VGS VP square law. So now ID we know already, IDSS is also given, and 1 minus VGS, we don't know VGS, and VP is given. So if you solve this one, you will get VGSS is equal to 1 minus 1.5 volt. Now VGSS is equal to 1 minus 1.5 volt. Now gate source voltage VGSS, we can write VG minus VS here. VGS is equal to voltage at this point minus voltage at this point. So in our example now, VGS is nothing but VG minus VS. What is VS? VS is nothing but ID and RS. So if you substitute this one, then we will get ID into RS is equal to 5.5 volt, because we know one quantity here, that is we know from the above VGS is equal to minus 1.5 volt, and if you substitute this one, you will get this one, and from this you will get RS is equal to 5.5 divided by 5 into 10 is 1.1 kilo ohm you will get. So you will take the above equation, VGS is equal to VG minus VS, right? VGS is equal to minus, we got VGS is equal to, VGS is equal to, in the above equation we got like, what is the value of VGS is equal to minus 1.5 volt, we got VGS is equal to minus 1.5 volt is equal to VG minus VS. VG is given 4 minus VS. So now I will take this this to this side and this to this side, that time this becomes VS is equal to 5.5. Now 5.5 volt. Now VS is the thing, but I can write ID and RS and 5.5. Now we know ID is equal to drain current, you know. By using that, we can find out RS is equal to 1.1. R is equal to 1.1. Now, one more parameter assumed that RD is equal to 4 times of RS. So what is RD now? 4 into RS, that is 4.4. Now we have to find out. R1 and R2. Now we got RS, RD, R1 and R2 we have to find out. How to find out R1 and R2? Now I will take you to this equation, this diagram. So in this diagram you can see, now we got this one and this one. Now how to find out these two parameters? So in this case, when two parameters are unknown, then it is difficult to find out. So what we will do here is, we will try to find out one parameter R2. We will try to assume one of the resistance at 1 kilo ohm, and then I need to find out 3 kilo ohm. Now let R2 is 1 kilo ohm. Now what is VG according to Kirchhoff's law? According to Kirchhoff's law, see, VG is R2 divided by R2 divided by R1 plus R2, R1 plus R2 into voltage supply. This one VDD 16, that is voltage drop across this one, voltage drop across this one. That is according to Kirchhoff's law for the input loop. VDD, we know VDD minus voltage drop across this one, voltage drop across this one is equal to 0. So to find out this one, now to find out this one, what we can do, like R2 into 16 divided by R1 plus R2. If you use this equation, applying Kirchhoff voltage law, then we know R2 is equal to 16, and R1 we don't know. If you solve this one, you will get R1 is equal to 3 kilo ohm. So this is the one method. So dear students, somewhat confusing. This is called as voltage divider bias method. Here four resistance. Actually, we need to find out the value of R1, R2, RS, RD. But RD. So in the example, what we did, we solved for RD, RS. So and we assumed R2 1 kilo ohm. By using voltage Kirchhoff's laws, so we can know VG is equal to voltage drop across this one to total resistance into VDD. So by using that formula, we try to find out R1.